Capital Oil and Gas. Chief Dr. Chika Okafor. Mwachine Melu Newi. Chika Singh Group.
Daddy Sobaya.
Chief Dr. Innocent Chukuma. Ife their son Newi. CEO Innocent Group.
I salute you, sir.
Still the red carpet, and we are live at the 57th Ofala of Igwe Orizu CON, celebrating it with the good people of Nnewi as he confers chief thanks and titles to illustrious sons of Anambra and of Nnewi. Right beside me on the red carpet is Professor Kingsley Mohalo. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you.
All right, first, we would like to congratulate you on the conferment of this chief thanks and title today.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your congratulations.
Okay, now moving on to the question. Next year is going to be a very eventful one for the good people of Anambra State. What are we expecting from you as a person, as the former deputy CBN governor, and as a leader? What should we be expecting from you come next year?
Well, I will always be available to contribute to the development of Anambra State. I am aware that next year will be the governorship elections. My prayer is that many very well qualified candidates will emerge on various political parties. And when we are spoiled for choice with very competent candidates, may we be able to select the best one. That's my prayer, that Anambra State will get governorship governance right in 2021.
Yeah. Last year you contested for a presidency.
Yes.
Now I want to switch this question a bit, you know, to the economic part of this country. Being the former deputy CBN governor,
yes,
and with the way, you know, the current economic is going, the downturns and all,
yes,
what would you say that this and this should be done to make the economy better?
The first thing that we need to do to make the economy better is to cut the cost of governance. Then we need to diversify away from relying on oil. We need to make the naira to be exchanged at the market exchange rate, so that you don't have these false subsidies and hoarding and parallel market. If the naira is exchanged on the market, so many millions of dollars will come into the country looking for profit. In that process, the value of the dollar will fall. Also, it will now stop, you know, it will discourage people from importation, because importation becomes expensive. So they will now export in order to earn dollars. Now, at the same time, we must handle policy concerning trade. That is to say, anything that is imported, there must be a tariff on it that makes it more expensive than locally produced goods, such as innocent vehicles. They should be cheaper than foreign vehicles. That way, we will be encouraged to buy local. You see the point? But all these policies must happen together. in an organized way, not in a disjointed way.
All right, so finally, on a lighter note,
yes,
what are your words of felicitations to the Igwe and the people of Nnewi?
Well, I thank the Igwe of Nnewi, Kenneth Orizu III, for conferring this title on me. Ifekego Nnewi, Ifekego Nnewi. It means somebody or something that is bigger than money. It is a recognition of my contribution to the community in Nnewi and in Anambra State and in Nigeria and in the world. It is a recognition that integrity and character matter more than material things. So I'm very, very happy today, very pleased. Very pleased.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
I am on the red carpet with the chairman, 57th Ofala celebration of Igwe Kenneth Orizu. But first, I'd like him to introduce himself. May we meet you, sir?
Yes, my name is Ezra Kuku Emmanuel Nsedo, PhD, the chairman of 2020 Ofala Committee, Planning Committee.
All right, so far, how has the planning been? Because I know that planning has lots to do with organizing, you know, controlling, bringing things together. How has it been? What are the challenges and how were you and your team able to surmount it?
Well, if you look at the environment, you know, putting everything together will be a big challenge. But all it takes is to bring the right kind of people together. So if you look at the environment, the aesthetics, you will notice that what we have here is a different thing from what it used to be in the past, both from an entertainment point of view and putting up an environment that is very welcoming. I mean, the ambience is quite impressive, you must tell. So it took a lot of work, time and planning to arrive at where we are, and we have a very good cooperation from the Crown Prince, His Royal Highness Prince Obi Orizu.
All right, you have really, really sold out the event, and I bet you are a good PR. I would say I am impressed. Anyways, the way you put in, you know, the way you explained everything that has happened so far. Now, finally, on a lighter note, what are your congratulatory messages to the Igwe and his cabinet on the occasion today?
Well, you have to remember first and foremost that our Igwe is a specially gifted person from God. A very humble, very strong. You can see it for yourself at 95 years, moving up and down and handling hours and hours of events without breaking down. So we keep praying for God to keep blessing him with good health and strength. And to the Royal Cabinet, we want them to keep imbibing the spirit of Solomon in adjudicating matters and advising His Royal Highness to always be on the right path.
Thank you so very much.
You're most welcome. Thank you very much.
Right here with me, I have the pleasure of standing with architect Paul Ileka, a Rotarian and a humanitarian par excellence. He's popularly called Solid Base. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, thank you.
All right, so today that the Igwe is celebrating his Ofala and the good people of Nnewi are celebrating this alongside him, what is the significance of Ofala celebration to Igbo as a people?
The Ofala to Igbo as a people is a celebration, whereby an annual celebration that we normally do to pay homage to the our royal fathers by way of coming to the palace and greet the Igwe who is doing the Ofala celebration and pay homage to him that we are still royal to his throne. So that is the significance of Ofala and thanking God for his life too.
Now, so quick one, what are your congratulatory or felicitations to the king and to the people of Nnewi today?
We are still thanking God for the life we have given to our Igwe. 95 years in the throne and still strong. And mentally, physically, he is strong. So it is not a small feat. It's the highest longest monarch who have been ruling in Africa, and to God be the glory, the man is still strong. So we thank God and still thanking God for his life and the health that he keep on providing for Igwe. So, my prayer is that Igwe will reach the golden age of 100 years, still in the throne.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Anedo.
All right, this is still the red carpet, live at the 57th Ofala of Igwe Orizo, C-O-N. And with me is...
Valentine Ozibo.
Okay. You're welcome, Valentine Ozibo. Today is a very, very special day, and it's very particular. You know, it's particular to the people of Nnewi, as the Igwe is celebrating his Ofala, and he has conferred illustrious sons of Anambra State chieftaincy title. What is the significance of this celebration to you and to Ndi Igbo in particular?
I'm happy you use that word Ndi Igbo, because Mehmet today Abra for Ndi Nnewi alone is for the entirety of Anambra people and Alebo. Igwe Orizo is a revered personality. He's somebody that has stood the test of time. He's a tested and trusted leader, Nana traditional council. He is actually the oldest in the throne. He's been there now for 57 years, and at this rightful age, still waxing stronger, still providing energetic leadership. It can only be God. So I am here to felicitate and thank God for him and wish him the well. I am coming up for governorship of Anambra State, and I'd like him to work with me on the day I mount the saddle of office. And that's why I'm here, to pay homage and hopefully share in the joy that Ndi Igbo are sharing today. I am very particular about what can bring, you know, tourism potential to bear. And let's see how can unfold what Anambra has got to offer in both the traditional institutions, cultural institutions, entertainment, and what have you. And this is what this represents. It's a fulcrum of all of this put together. And I'm very excited that we have an amazing gentleman who has been on this throne before I was even born and stood there waxing stronger. And God, please protect this man and let him walk the aisle with me as I mount the saddle of office.
Okay, so finally, next year is going to be eventful for Ndi Anambra. Yes. So what are we expecting from you now? What are we expecting come next year?
Next year is 2021. It is an eventful year. It's the year that finally competency will have the order of the day in politics. It finally when the people's voice will matter. When indeed we can say goodbye to the old order. When we can begin to challenge the status quo, and when we begin to set a new standard for governance, and when we will change the story of a black man in the world, when Valentine Ozibo will take over as next governor of Anambra State, and Anambra will chawapo. That's the beginning of a new dawn.
Okay, so finally, what are your congratulatory messages to Igwe and his cabinet, and also the people of Nnewi?
My wishes for them, number one, continue to live in peace. I wish them peace. Number two, have fun as you celebrate. And number three, be respectful to elders, and also be respectful to the younger ones. The youth actually has got what it takes to deliver the dividends that we're seeking for. Let's give more voice to the youth, and also the women. We want to see more women empowered in everything that happens. My wish for Nnewi, as this is the symbol of what actually happens around the Igbo land, is that we begin to see these changes. I wish them well. I wish them greater celebrations. I wish Igwe longer life, healthier life. I wish him and his family everything that they need for a wonderful life in this world. And in the end, I wish that everybody was to live a life that would be worthy of eternal kingdom, because that's what we are going to.
All right. Thank you for joining us.
God bless you. God bless you.
Thank Dr. Cosmos Master, CEO Costaris Group.
And I make a lady, sir.
Norma, Chief Adadiora Mpande, Ochile Osuba,
Ezipo Inde,
Prince Chiedu Orizu, Ugunaya,
Orizu Motus.
To the end of the 57th 7th Ofala celebration of Igwe Kenneth Orizu, C-O-N. Today has been eventful because sons, illustrious sons of Nnewi and of Anambra State were conferred chieftaincy titles. Today we had so much fun, and of course Anedo TV is ever ready and ever present to give you the best of television experience. My name is Blessing Belo, and I am signing out.